person did not reveal that to you.
Mm-hmm. There has to be a time when God tells you who Jesus was.
Yes, mm-hmm. Amen.
Who he is. What he can do. Because even though in the society we're living in today, and everybody believes in God, they say, everybody believes in Jesus, and they all have some inkling of who he was, but they don't really have an understanding of who he is. They have what they were, what they have concocted to their head. In other words, they've learned it from past experiences and from this person and that person, and they have formed a picture of who Christ is. Mm-hmm. We can sit in a church service and we can listen and be in church consecutively, and we hear a certain understanding of who Christ is. Yeah. But you're not going to learn who Christ is that way. The only way a person can receive who Christ is, there has to be a revelation come from God.
Yes.
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
Now can you see why Jesus said to Peter, "You're blessed, buddy. You're blessed. Because you didn't get this from flesh and blood. You got it from God through revelation." And that is the only way that I can build my life on, is if I have that revelation. I've got to have that revelation working in my spirit and in my heart. Now, if you don't have that revelation yet, you're still here for a purpose. God brought you here.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. How many feel like God brought you here?
Amen.
He brought you here. Well, while you're here, and you're among us, and you're walking this way and walking that way, and we're doing things together, we're laboring together, and we're doing the things and the thought pattern together. In other words, we're mingling and we're working together. The revelation of who Jesus is, I can't put that into your heart. I can tell you about him, and I can give you the principles of how he is or who he is, but that revelation has to come from God Almighty. Praise the Lord. Because if it was any other way, then I would be adding you. If it was done any other way, you would be doing it.
Amen.
But this has to be a revelation from the Lord.
Yes, yes.
God, give us that revelation,
yes,
to the degree that we need it.
Yes.
Can you lift your hands up and just say, Lord, let us have that revelation.
Jesus, Jesus.
Praise the name of the Lord. Now, look what he said. He said, "But my Father which is in heaven, he's revealed it. And I say also unto thee that you're Peter." Peter, you're Peter. You are who you are. But it's not you. I can't build a church on you. Now, Catholicism has built, he's the foundation, he's the rock. But he's trying to show them and tell them, you're Peter. But upon this rock. What was that rock? That was the revelation,
yes,
of who Jesus is.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes.
And you can get that intellectually, but you've got to get it in your heart. You've got to absolutely know him, that he is the Christ of the living God. How many see what I'm trying to say right here?
Amen.
Because I can't get it out just like I want to, but everybody understand.
Yeah.
You can intellectually know who he is. You can intellectually know him.
Amen.
But there is nothing at all like knowing him in a personal relationship.
Yeah.
And know
that he is God's son. Praise his wonderful name.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. He is God's son. Not because, not just because I understand him to be, or intellectually I believe he is, but I can feel it. Praise the name of God. Let me see what I'm saying right there. You can feel it. Oh, I know he's the son of God. Nobody has to tell me.
Brother Zonneveld.
Sit, Brother Burke.
Where would you put your scripture?
All right.
In the power of his resurrection.
In the
fellowship of his suffering.
Yes. That we be made conformable.
Thank you, Lord.
Unto his death. Praise the name of the Lord. Mm-hmm. Oh, you know, sometimes I have a hard time expressing myself, but I hope you're sensing what I'm saying.
Yes, yeah. Amen.
Because it has to come. I have to know.
Yes.
If I'm doing it just intellectually, I'm going to fail.
Yes.
I will not make it. I know he's the son. How do I know he's the son of God? Okay, God. Prove it to me who you are. Prove it to me. No. That's not the way he works. But he can show you. You can feel him.
Thank you, Lord.
You can feel his presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
You can feel what God is, who he is, who Jesus is. And if you haven't got that foundation, because see, remember what he said? Oh, I didn't read that part yet. Or did I? And upon this rock, what? What is he going to build? That.
Yes.
That revelation.
The son of the living God.
That's how the foundation of the church must stand.
Yes.
Oh, God. You know what? There is no room for speculation there. There's no room for hesitation. How many will help me pray?
Yes, amen.
I want to pray that God will touch every single heart in this place.
Amen.
And let them have the experience with Christ of not as a figure that's somewhere in the heavens or in the past, a figure that I've formed in my mind because of material that I've read, but that I will know him.
Yes, amen.
And to know somebody is very intimate.
Yes.
It's very intimate. It's an experience.
Yes, it is.
Now, I can say, well, I know him because I've been taught. Oh, my God, yes. I've been taught. Look at me, I'm really something. I've been taught. But I can know him by out of the pages of this book.
Right.
But buddy, let me tell you something. That's only intellect.
Yes, amen.
And that Peter was trying to tell, or Jesus was trying to tell those disciples, get the foundation right.
Yes.
Get it right.
Yes.
Not only be, Brother Donald, this is elementary, this is basic. I've heard this all the day of my life. I've heard it all my life. Well, there's a reason why I'm telling you this.
Amen.
Because we've got to feel this revelation.
Yes, we do. Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, God, send us this revelation. Well, I've had that for years, Brother Zonneveld. Yeah, well, there's a reason why God's bringing it up now.
Yes, there is.
Because the church, the early church was built on that revelation. Now let's go to the next one. After they were on that proper foundation, go down to 16, go back up. No, Mark 16, I'm sorry. Mark 16, 16 through 20 is the verses we're dealing with now. After they were on the foundation, and only on the foundation, there were signs that followed him, followed his disciples. The word was confirmed. Let's read it. Simon Peter answered. Oh, that's Matthew yet. Okay.
Mark what? You said 16 through 20, but you didn't give a chapter.
Yeah, 16 chapters.
Oh, okay, and 21st. Okay.
He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. He that believeth not shall be damned. Pretty plain language.
Yes.
And these signs shall follow them that believe in my name. They shall cast out devils.
So for us to accomplish that, and we certainly, and let me just make it plain, we certainly don't want to heal people and to cast out devils to be recognized. There's enough of that going on television.
Yeah.
Yes.
To be recognized. That's not what I'm saying, but he's saying these signs, these evidences shall follow them that believe. That belief in the foundation principle of the church, that he is Christ, the Son of the living God, in a relationship experience, not in just knowledge experience, but in a relationship experience. And when that principle is there, there'll be signs. They'll cast out devils. Sometimes the devil is, you know, we talked about the subject of the devil. I don't want to go back there, so just write in a question if you want more on that. But when he said he cast out devils, right there he's talking about more than one devil, incidentally. I said I wasn't going to go in there. But he said they went about casting out devils, and he went, and the sign was there. A true gospel that's built on the foundation of Christ being, and that revelation being there, that gospel that's preached, as I illustrated to you earlier, that if we do not forsake to look into the mirror and have the word of God come forth, there'll be some devils come out of us that'll come out of our spirit and of our hearts and our nature. Now, does that mean, though, that if this church, let me rephrase that, if this church is in divine order and in the right place, God might send a person that's demoniac spirited, and they have a devilish spirit in them, and it's not to say that we cannot lay hands on them and that devil come out of him.
Yep.
But we've got to get the foundation right.
Yes, we do.
We don't need it as the world does it. We need it as God wants it done.
Yes.
Because these signs shall follow them that believe.
Yes.
Confirming what?